Hello everyone and welcome back to another exciting and amazing chess game from the history of chess. And in this chess game, White is the first world official chess champion, Wilhelm Steinitz, and his opponent is Edward Kortner. And this game was played in 1865 in Dublin, Ireland. And in this chess game, let me give you some interesting information about this chess game. Wilhelm Steinitz at this time in 1865. I believe he was 29 years old, and on the other hand, his opponent was 70 years old. So Kortner was 41 years older than Steinitz, but Wilhelm Steinitz was not going to show any respect to his elders in this chess game. I'm sure in his real life, he was a well-mannered gentleman, but in chess, he shows no respect. So let's check out how this game went on. So Wilhelm Steinitz, who has the white pieces, starts the game with playing e4, e5, f4. We have the King's Gambit, declined. E takes on d5. Well, this was the Falkbeer counter gambit, not accepting the King's Gambit. So what happens if capturing the e-pawn? Then obviously, we have checking the king with the queen, checking the king. So let's say blocking the queen, but then capturing the pawn. But Wilhelm Steinitz was not a fish, even when he was blindfolded. So he played e takes on d5. Of course, f takes on e5 would be a blunder. And then Kortner played e takes on f4 and knight to f3, queen takes on d5, attacking the queen, queen to e6, checking the king. Wilhelm Steinitz liked to walk his king. He liked to take his king to a walk, so he played king to f2, even though this move seems ridiculous. This was actually fine. Steinitz played these type of moves many times in his chess games, and he get away with it, but he was usually fine. Defending the king, and if checking the king, pushing the pawn, and then developing the bishop. So strangely, the king is looking safe after king to f2. Also, Wilhelm Steinitz said that the king is a fighting piece, use it. So we have king to f2. He liked to activate his king. But of course, in modern chess, this is not a good idea. After king to f2, we have bishop to d6, and this was a blunder. Let's take it back. Well, knight to c6 should have been considered in this position, but we have bishop to d6. And what would you do in this position? Well, Steinitz played the strongest move. He played bishop to b5, checking the king and moving the king. If blocking the bishop, then rook to e1. And black is losing the queen, so let's take it back. After checking the king, moving the king. And then rook to e1, once again, attacking the queen. And we have bishop to e5, blocking with the bishop, but this is losing the bishop and the chess game. So let's take it back. What happens if running away? Then here comes rook to e8, checkmate. Black is getting checkmated and there is no defense. In this position, after rook to e1, we have bishop to e5, but then Steinitz captured the bishop, rook takes on e5, checking the king, saving the queen, blocking, and knight to d7, not allowing checkmate. And knight to d5, attacking the queen. What a beautiful move by Steinitz, sacrificing the bishop. It looks like he forgot about the bishop, but we have queen to d6. In this position, what happens if capturing the bishop, if queen takes on b5? What would you do in this position? Would you capture the pawn with the knight? Well, that is forking the queen and the rook, and discover attacking the queen. Well, rook to e8 is stronger, checking the king and sacrificing the rook. In this position, the only move, king takes on e8. And here comes knight takes on c7, forking the king and the queen. So losing the queen by force, if capturing the bishop. So this is why Wilhelm Steinitz is sacrificing the bishop for capturing the queen. But we have queen to d6. Wilhelm Steinitz simply captured the knight, bishop takes on d7, bishop takes on d7. And then here comes bishop takes on f4, bishop to e6, queen to d2, knight to f6, and then Steinitz captured the knight, capturing back with the pawn, attacking the rook. But like I said, Wilhelm Steinitz shows no respect to his elders, and he played rook takes on e6, sacrificing the rook, sacrificing the exchange. And Kortner captured the rook with the queen. That was a discover attack to the queen, so what else? Capturing back with the queen, but then Steinitz has the open file, rook to e1, attacking the queen, queen to f5, and pushing the pawn, not capturing, Checking the kick. The only square for the kick. What would you do in this position? Which move is the best move? Well, there is a move which is a must in this position. Can you find that move? A very simple move. Well, Stein is played. Knight to h4, attacking the queen. And where is the queen going? Attacking the queen. The queen is under attack. And Kortner captured the pawn. The only safe spot for the queen. But Stein is played. Rook to g1. And Kortner resigned. A brilliant chess game by Wilhelm Steinitz. So let me show you the possible continuation. So this is pinning the queen and winning the queen. In this position, let's say if capturing the rook, queen takes on g1, king takes on g1, and whatever black does, black is getting checkmated, queen to g2, checkmate. There is no defense. What a game. What an incredible attack by Wilhelm Steinitz. Indeed, he showed no respect to his elder. There was 41 years age difference between Steinitz and Kortner. But like I said, in his real life, he is a well-mannered, well-educated gentleman. But in chess, he has no respect. He attacks like a grizzly bear, a wild bear. What an incredible attack by Wilhelm Steinitz. In chess, he is a ferocious attacker and an aggressive player. And thank you for watching. And eventually, black is getting checkmated. So this is why, in this position, after rook to g1 by Steinitz, Kortner resigned. And thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time. Take care, and bye-bye.